so excited for you to hear the message that's upon her heart, and we pray that God will open your minds, your hearts, to and your ears to hear what it is that God wants you to hear today. So as we celebrate today, just a couple quick announcements. Sunday evening, our worship time will be celebrated with the women's choir, who will be singing for the first time this semester, and the Second Chance Praise team will lead us in music. And the message of the evening is, how do you love? How do you love? Saturday evening mass, 7 o'clock here in the chapel. And again, make sure that you welcome our new priest, Father Michael, I believe. Is that right? That sounds right. So, great guy. Okay. Chapel speakers next week, Kiersey Doherty and Christian Friday. So that's Monday and Friday next week. An awesome lineup of seniors who are able to share with us. Coming up next weekend, we want you to be aware of a special speaker who's coming to visit Westminster, Reverend Dr. Patricia Tall, who is an retired Old Testament professor from Louisville Seminary, or Louisville Seminary, as I know to say it. And she is going to be sharing with us thoughts on from Eden to the present, and how as Christians we're called to care for the creation that is around us. And she'll be here for Sunday evening worship, Monday chapel, and then Monday evening she's going to share some thoughts from her recent book. And then we have a panel discussion that will feature Helen Boylan and Tim Cuff and a couple of other folks with her. So we invite you to come and be part of all those things. If you're interested in an alternative spring break with a purpose trip, I know it's a little bit early, but we are already taking signups for the trips, and you can do that by stopping in the Office of Faith and Spirituality. Your cost is $25, plus helping with some fundraising. Right now, we know that one team is going to be going to Georgetown, South Carolina, which is in the Myrtle Beach area, and the second team we will not know until next week once we go through the Habitat for Humanity sign-up process, and we'll let you know where that group is going to go at that time. This Wednesday evening, if you're interested in alternative types of worship services, a group of students are going down to East Liberty Presbyterian Church to a Taze worship service. The group will leave Westminster about 4:30 or 5, eat dinner in Pittsburgh, and then attend worship at East Liberty Pres for their Taze service, and then back to campus after that. So there's the sign-up sheet for that so that we don't miss anyone. If you'd like to go along, just add your name to the list. Even if you are thinking about it, you're just not sure, so that we know, we can get in contact with you with some extra information about it. So if you'll pass this back to the, when it gets back in the back, if you'll jump it over to the other side, that'd be great. Friends, I invite you to listen to these words as we prepare for our time together today. This comes from Psalm 66. Shout with joy to God, all the earth. Sing the glory of his name. Make his praise glorious. Say to God, how awesome are your deeds. So great is your power that your enemies cringe before you. All the earth bows down to you. They sing praise to you. They sing praise to your name. Let us pray. Lord, we shout to you as we move into this season of the year, this season of fall, this season of homecomings, this season when we are faced with the realities of midterms and all the other pressures of being here. We pray that you will give us time to be able to take in the creation that you provided for us, while also time to focus our studies. Lord, as we gather today, we pray for your presence. We pray that you would speak to us today through Maria. May the music we hear today, may the words of scripture that are read, may her words all be your words. We ask this in your son's name. And together we say, amen.
Be thou my vision, O Lord of my heart. Not be all else. with thee one. I, King of heaven, my victory won, may I reach and choice a bright heaven's sun. Heart of my own heart, whatever befall, still be my vision, O ruler of all.
The first reading comes from 1 Thessalonians. For God did not appoint us to suffer wrath, but to receive salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ. He died for us so that whether we are awake or asleep, we may live together with him. Therefore, encourage one another and build each other up, just as in fact you are doing.
The second reading comes from Ephesians chapter 3, verses 16 through 19. I pray that out of his glorious riches he may strengthen you with power through his Spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power, together with all the Lord's holy people, to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ, and to know this love that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God.
Hi, everyone. When Maria first asked me to introduce her today, I was dumbstruck. Not in a bad way, but because I had no idea how to put our friendship or the type of person she is into words, which is saying a lot because I'm an English major. I knew I could tell stories of our late night talks, endless words of encouragement, and all of the laughter and tears we have shared over the past 3 years, but I thought that those things simply could not do her justice. Instead, I chose to turn to the internet. I scoured quotes and sayings, trying to find the perfect thing to say. When I lost all hope in Google, I turned to her second best friend, Pinterest. She had a board named Quotes I Love, and she had a lot of options with it. I immediately found two that embodied Maria in every sense. The first from Maya Angelou. I think a hero is any person really intent on making this world a better place for all people. Although we have not found our place in the real world, I think everyone in this room can agree that Maria has made Westminster a better place. Through her genuine smile, big hugs, and excited wave, she has been known to be a daymaker. On top of that, she has welcomed hundreds of first years through Fresh Start, convinced countless people on their choices of Westminster and SWAT, brightened the nights of the community by sharing her Irish dancing skills at dance theater, and she balances the entire SGA budget. I could continue on and on about all she has done for our campus and the numerous organizations she is involved in, but instead I would rather call her our hero for truly making this a better place for all of us. I want to end with the last quote I stole off of her Pinterest. Too often we underestimate the power of a touch, a smile, a kind word, a listening ear, an honest compliment, or the smallest act of caring, all of which have the potential to turn a life around. Maria, you've turned so many lives around. I couldn't be more blessed to have you as my best friend. I promise I won't read any more quotes. Instead, I'm so incredibly honored to introduce Maria McTighe.
Wow, hello everyone. I want to thank you so much for coming. It means so much to me that I see all of your beautiful faces. It really means a lot. I want to thank my mom and my dad for coming to support me. I see my dad's face already. and Colin, my brother, one of them. You support me in everything, and I'm so thankful that God has blessed me with wonderful people who surround me in my life constantly, every single day, like my family and all of you who are here. I couldn't ask for anything else. So, bear with me here. So as I started gathering thoughts about what I would say at my chapel, I went to my dear friend Jenny Jones's chapel last Friday, and I read scripture at it, and I was like, how do I do a chapel after that? Like, it was just awesome, and so awesome job, Jenny. But after thinking more, I took a lot of good advice away from her, as I always do. I kept worrying about what I would say or how I would say it and if it would make sense and if I could make it my own. And then I thought and I said, Maria, stop worrying and listen to what Jenny said. Be genuine and state your own thoughts. So thank you, Jenny. Now, I want you to think of someone that you know or who have you've met that is a really jolly person. Someone who's always laughing, and it seems as if their whole being is just filled to the brim with smiles and love. Can you picture someone like that? Well, Pop-Up is what I like to call this person for me. I don't know if he's up there. this is my grandpa. If I don't bring you a smile, I hope this picture does today. He is really messy, and that's chocolate on his nose, and he loves sweets. So he's what I like to call this person, as him and his 53 other grandchildren like to call him. He's always been a huge influence in my life in more than one way. He is that old man who will stop and have a 15-minute conversation with a complete stranger because he just wants to be their friend. We often have to like lure him away from people so he doesn't break their plans, but the jolliness that I have seen throughout my childhood from my Pop-Up is who he is as a person. But even as he often says, the source of his joy comes from someone above and beyond. I will always remember the little conversations I often have with my Pop-Up, and there's one I will never forget from a couple years ago. He was just telling me about his morning and how he had went to church. And he said, you know, Rhea, whenever I'm in Mass, I always love looking around at everyone, and I focus on the children, and it always fills me with joy because you can just see God in their faces, and you can just see God through them and the face of God through them. And while I've reflected back on that moment, I find that my Pop-Up's wisdom is so true. Love can be such a complicated concept, and many times people think that love has to be felt to be real. But what I think, and sometimes I even confuse myself, is that love can be seen. And it's given to us all day, every single day, by someone who never fails, and that's God. God fills us up with love all the time. And it's up to you to accept that love and show it to others through a smile or a tight hug. Thanks, Harry Green. And as one of my favorite quotes from Mother Teresa says, every time you smile at someone, it's an action of love. It really reflects back on that person. And it can be easily seen because it's always there and it shines through everyone and everything is an action. And another one of my favorite things about this campus is that it's so beautiful. I think we can all agree on that. And I often find myself walking on campus and to class or to a meeting and marveling in the beauty of it. And especially this year, for my walk to the townhouse instead of Ferg, which is a lot longer, I say, I love looking up at the bright blue sky or the morning fog, and I say, hey, thanks God, I needed that. It's like a constant reminder that beauty is everywhere and his love is everywhere. You just have to open your eyes to see it. Anyone who shows love to others through passion or just through them is also sharing his love because she shines through you. The next time you're having a bad day or you're down in the dumps, try to look at the positives or pick out one beautiful surrounding around you and focus on that positive. Focus on that good in the world. Because when you can take a step back and look at the bigger picture, you'll find that there's always something better. There's always someone who's in a worse off situation than you. And you can be thankful for that. Just as Abby, Erin, Chloe, and Rachel beautifully sang, thanks girls, be thou my vision, O Lord of my heart, my presence, my light. His light will be there to unfold in front of you everything that is beautiful and good. When you fill your heart with passions, it becomes easier to focus on those things that make you happy. So one of the other things I love about Westminster are the mysterious little notes that can end up in random mailboxes. And maybe some of you have gotten these, and I don't know who gives them out. But it always fills my heart to see people showing love and getting mail, and maybe encouraging someone that they don't even know. I know I always love getting mail, even if it's that reminder from the Career Center to check off if you want to attend the etiquette dinner, because it's just something little to show that you're there. But I know a little note in a mailbox or on your door can always put a smile on your face. And just like showing love through a smile, God can be shown through encouragement in our lives. Now, encouragement has to have a source to be shown or shared to someone. What allows a person to give encouragement? I had asked this question to myself while I was writing this. And maybe it's that you can empathize with that person who needs a boost in life. Or maybe you just want to show positive, like, vibes to that energy, to that someone. Or maybe, if you've ever thought about it, it's that spirit that is within that positive person that allows for them to rub off on others. That positive spirit builds us up so that we may have the strength to build others up in turn. It's like a constant cycle. It's a magnetic force, and when you're able to see love and show it to others, you pass on that strength to allow for another opportunity to build another person up that you might not even know. And just as Adam read in 1 Thessalonians 5, 9 through 11, it reads, "Therefore, encourage one another and build up one another, just as you are also doing." When you're able to motivate others, it allows for you to reflect on how proud you can be of that person. That's always my favorite thing to look back on. And it's as if you are so full with love and encouragement that your inner being is bursting so that it has nowhere else to go but to be given to others. So give a small compliment to someone who might not be smiling so bright that day, or tell someone how much you appreciate them and what they do. I promise you the encouragement and love given to that person will in return fill your heart as well. God's plan to strengthen us is so that it bounces off of us and onto others as a chain reaction. So continue the chain and keep linking those together. With love and strength given to us, I've also learned that I must put my faith and trust in God no matter what, which can be really hard in those moments in life when you feel as if the love and strength isn't quite reaching out to you, or those moments are really fuzzy and you don't know where to go next. So on February 1st of last year, I never thought I would have to be put in such a situation where all I had left was to rely on prayer and God's plan. And having to hear my mom say on the phone that my dad had had a massive heart attack and was barely alive at that moment tore at my heart. I can imagine that this would be a similar feeling to as if your world was collapsing around you. You feel so helpless, and I had no other reaction than to call on my... From the moment I hung up the phone until I heard the most important words of my life from my dad ringing, "I love you," I never stopped praying. There were constant Our Fathers and Hail Marys running through my mind as a Catholic girl, and those you can vouch for, those with me can vouch for that. I just started saying them out loud. And after being thankful that he's alive and that he's sitting in that pew right now, I'm positive that God heard our prayers, and I don't think my dad could have gotten through without them and without all of you who were praying. This experience and others have proven to me that God is always at our side. He's holding our hands, guiding us through life. And what is so amazing to me, I didn't cry whenever I was saying this, so sorry, is that no matter what, no matter how many times we turn our backs on him, it's as if he's waiting on the other side to pick up right where you left off with him. Many times he's saying, "I can help you. Let me give you my love, because I have so much." Jenny read from Ephesians chapter 3, 16 through 19. "And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power together with all the Lord's holy people to grasp how wide and long and deep is the love of Christ." His love is so deep, and it's sometimes unfathomable. I have a hard time grasping it myself, and Until you put it into action and trust in God to strengthen you, that's when you can feel it. One of my other all-time favorite verses that a good friend of mine lived her life by was Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Many times in life, we have those days where we think we can't solve a problem or we have too much to handle and we just can't get by it. But as we turn our cares to Him, He's sometimes and always there to give us strength. And through this strength, we are then able to push it onto others. So take that strength given and learn to love life with all its successes, its failures, and the confusion of it. So when I was growing up, I had this constant picture in my mind of what God's day was like. And I have this image of Him in this huge library with a bunch of books that are stacked high in these huge shelves. And each person is a book. And I've always thought that my life is another one of His books, individually titled Maria McTighe. And when things wouldn't go my way, or I had a goal that wasn't achieved, I was always really disappointed. And I would think, like, why couldn't you do that, Maria? Why me? What else could I have done better? And then I would go back to that image, and I'd think, that moment of my life wasn't written in my book. Everything happens for a reason, and it's not as if God can be the only one writing your book, but He is the one guiding the pen that you write your book with. So open your eyes to those beautiful things that make you happy, and make every day shine for someone who might be in a cloud, and trust that when something goes wrong, there's always a better answer or a better sentence coming up in your book. Thank you.
Also makes us think and makes our heart kind of say, God, I'm so glad that you're here and part of our lives and my life. And God has a book in that big old library. And I think we're all part of that library. And the best part is, God knows our name and calls us by name. So as you go out today, go out remembering the words you've heard. Remember this message. Remember that God's love goes with you wherever you go. Spend time in prayer. Spend time reflecting on the creation. Smile at someone, laugh at someone, and know that when you offer God's love to someone else, you get back a whole lot more than you ever gave. Go forth in peace, and together we say, amen. Great job. And alums, welcome. I forgot to do that. Welcome, alums.